I have created a Chrome extension that helps you push data layer events to Google Tag Manager without the need of having any technical background at all. You don't need to be aware or to be an expert with any programming language that is out there like JavaScript or even HTML. So let's get started. I'll show you how this works. And at the end of the video, I'll show you how to install the plugin or the extension. So I'm currently on my website where I have this product page and I have the Chrome extension installed. So it will look like this. So let's go through the fields real quickly. The first thing, it's asking us to add like an event name, like the add to cart, view item. This is totally up to you. This is based on the information that the data layer event would push. So let's assume that we want to push a data layer event once the user adds a product to the shopping cart. So our event name in this case would be add to cart. So let's add this. Let's use this format without any spacing. And then it asks us to add a selector, trigger selector. So for this one, this is basically when the data layer event should fire. This is the condition. So how to get that selector? Let's right click on the element or the button that we wish to fire the data layer event when the user clicks on. Hit inspect. This menu would pop up on your screen. At some cases, it might pop up from the downside or from the right side instead of the left side. So if that happened for you, just click on these three dots and select this option. So you get it exactly the way I have it right now, or use whatever you'd like. Now, as you can see, automatically, since I have inspected this button, when this pop-up menu opens, this is called, by the way, developer tools, the elements panel. Over here, you can see the naming convention. The element would be highlighted. So we need to get the class of the button that we wish to trigger the event based on. I know it might sound complicated for some of you, but it's not at all. It will take us minutes to finalize this. So as you can see, there are several parts of the code over here. We are only interested in this class text. As you can see, it have some text and then it have spaces. What we need to do here is just to take one part of this code without the spacing, any part of it. For example, we can take this, so product form, submit. So just gonna press Command C or Control C to copy this value. And there I want you with, while you are in this page or this section, you need to press Control F if you're using Windows or Command F. So what this does is that it opens this panel, search panel, so we can search for anything within this elements panel. And now we're just gonna add dot and paste what we have. So this is how we can get the selector or the CSS selector, so we can use it as a trigger. As simple as that, once I have pasted this with the dot without any extra spacing before it or after it, it automatically highlights that element. And as you can see, it highlights the add to cart button. So that's the value that we're gonna be using. Let's copy this and add it here. And then within the parameters section, we have two things that we need to add. So a key, we can add, for example, the product name. And then the value. So since we want to send or have a dynamic values in our data layer events, what we need to do is getting a selector as well. This ensures that whenever whatever product page that the user adds the product to shopping cart, it always gets or fetch the dynamic product name. So for example, the product name here is the collection snowboard. So the data layer event should have this title when the user adds a product to the shopping cart. So let's see the selector for this element. So hit inspect on the product name because this is the value that we want to have. And then as you can see, it shows us, let's first delete this and let's do this again. So inspect. So it highlights this element, the collection snowboard.liquid, and just above it, and this is what you always need to do. So just see what is the above element of what the inspect tool, or what is the element that inspect tool highlighted, and get the class. So here we have this product.titles or product underscore titles. Let's add this here. And remember, you need to add a dot. So let's add a dot and then paste. And now it highlights the title, and it also highlights it in the code. But here's the thing. In this scenario, we can see here that there is two results of this same selector, which is something that we want to avoid. We should only get one value, and we should only have a selector per element, or the value that we'd like to get information about. So what we're going to do is we're going to climb a bit to the element. So that's the class that we have taken, which is the product title. Then we're gonna climb up a little bit over here, and the title, which is actually this one, not the above one. So again, this is the class. So class product underscore title. We then, when we climb up a little bit, we can see that there is another class called product title. So let's use this one. So let's copy this one and come here and add it into the beginning of the search functionality over here. So paste it. Hit space, and at the beginning, add another dot. And now we have only one value, which is great. This is what we want. This is the method that we should be using. So it's, again, think of this as a tree. We get like the fruit itself. So you can think of the first class as an apple, and then we want to trace the branch where that apple came from. So we were here at this level, and this is the class that we had. So class equal, and then the class. Let's climb up a little bit. We see another class. So that's a branch. So we get the value as is without any spacing. Copy it. And before pasting it before the other class, we just need to add a dot and paste it. And now we're sure that this would work since it has only one value. So let's copy this and paste it over here. So that's what we need to have. If you want to add an additional parameters to the data layer event, you can also click on the add parameter option over here and scroll. You would see parameter two. So let's say that you want to have a price, to pass a price to this data layer event. So just need to add the parameter name, which is price, and then get the price CSS selector. So I have this prepared before the recording. So let me paste it over here. So I just pasted this price. And this one is a bit longer, but the reason is it's a bit longer because there are several elements on the screen that has the same selector. So let me show you. If I deleted this part, the first part, and then press enter, you would see that there is five results of these because there are other elements on the same page with the same class. So I needed to trace back up another level, so three levels, to make sure that I get the class of the price that's in this section. So you just need to follow up bit by bit, one by one, branch by branch, until you get one value. So let me add this here. Oh, not this one. Let's add the full class. And now we have like a data layer event name, which is add to cart, and a trigger for that data layer event. Now we want to see this in action. So head to console. It's a tab over here, and then clear everything. And then you have two options. Let's use the first one. So the first one is preview. And once you click it, you can see that there is a message asks you to copy this value and then paste it in the console. Before doing that, let's also click the generate. So the generate option asks us to copy this HTML code and add it to Google Tag Manager to see this event in action. But here's the thing. The first one is for the preview purpose only. So I have built this feature just for people to make sure that their DataLayer event would fire with the proper values before going to Google Tag Manager and then creating the custom HTML tag, adding this code and see if it will work. So let's try this. So paste the first value and hit enter. And also, as you can see, the script is available in here. You can use it from this section as well. So let's close this for now. And let's add to cart. So as you can see here, the event have fired. So event add to cart, and then it has some values. So it have this title. So the collection title snowboard liquid, which is the product name. And then it have this price, which is the product price as well. So this confirms that this setup will work. This custom HTML code will work in Google Tag Manager. So let's copy it and see. Let's copy it and paste it in Google Tag Manager. And by the way, I have also prepared this before the recording. So I have created this tag. So that's custom HTML tag in Google Tag Manager. When you go to Google Tag Manager, you just need to hit tags, new, and then select this type. This is the custom HTML option. And then you need to have the trigger set to fire on all pages or based on a click trigger, similar to what we had in the DataLayer event trigger. So we have this now. Let's preview and see if it will work in Google Tag Manager. But again, this piece of code in the custom HTML tag is not the one that I have copied and added to the console section. That's the other version that we got when we clicked on the generate button. So you need to be careful. You need to use that version in GTM and the other one in the console, because both will not work like in the other selection. So we're now using Google Tag Manager. We have all of our DataLayer events firing on the left-hand side menu. Let's come here and let's add to cart and go back. So as you can see, this is the DataLayer event, the custom HTML tag that I have placed in Google Tag Manager. This is what have pushed the add to cart event. This is what have pushed this DataLayer event. And when you expand it over here, you can see that the event is this in the exact way that I have put into the extension. And then we have two parameters. So one is this, second is this, price and name. So let's go to another product page and see if this would work. As you can see here, this product have a different price, it have a different name. So this would confirm if the DataLayer event will work as intended, if it will have the dynamic data that we want. So let's click add to cart, go back to the preview mode. We can see that this is the recent add to cart, and the product name is here is the multi-location snowboard, which is the same, and price is 729.95, which is the same as well. So that's it. You can build the custom event trigger based on this, and you can build also variables, which is what I have done. So I have prepared here two variables. These are like a DataLayer variables type, and I have created one for the price and one for the product name. If you are not sure how to create DataLayer variables from your DataLayer on your website using Google Tag Manager, you can check out my course. It's on the channel, or you can also use the DataLayer checker Chrome extension and then open the DataLayer event that you have created. Use the flat option. So click on this flat option. And let's say that you want to get this price set in DataLayer variable. You'll need to copy key. Just click on this one and go to GTM, create new DataLayer variable, and come here and paste. It will paste the key of that DataLayer variable. But I'm not going to do that because that's another variable. And lastly, you can add event trigger. That trigger, you can trigger events based on when this DataLayer event executes, which is something I have done. And by the way, you can use the event add dash to dash cart here in this scenario as the trigger. So I've created this dummy tag for as a demonstration purposes for this property. So the event name is add to cart, and then I'm passing the price and the name using the variables that I have just created. So let's go back to GTM, and this is our data layer event name. And this is the tag that I have created. Let's click on it. And when you do click on this or any tag in your container, make sure that you are using the values section so you can get the variables values instead of having this selected two names, because in this case, it would show you the data layer names only without the values, the actual values inside of them. So as you can see, the price here matches what we have in the data layer, matches what we have in the variables, and also the name. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Now let me walk you through on how to add this extension to your browser. So I'm currently using Chrome on MacBook. You would need to go to extensions. So just click on the three dots and then from settings, hit extensions, or click on this icon over here. You should have it as well. And then hit manage extensions. When you open this panel, make sure that developer mode option is enabled. And then you would need to load unpacked and select the data layer folder. So you would need to go to the file where you have downloaded this and check the whole folder. So for example, this is the folder itself. If we go back, these are the files itself. And this is the folder. You would need to select the folder then that contains the files directly. So select this, and what will happen is that it will add the data layer, or it will add the extension to your Chrome browser over here, the extension files. And then what you need to do is click on this pin option, so you have it always pinned to your extension bar. But yeah, that's basically it. I hope it helps. If you find this video helpful, I would appreciate it if you subscribe to my channel, like and share the video. And if you are still watching to this till this point, I really appreciate that you're watching the full thing. And yeah, have a great day. Thanks for watching.